Hitting all the headlines today, the doping scandal in athletics. An investigation has found that some Russian athletes used illegal substances to enhance their performances during the 2012 Games. Now, we're only 9 months away, of course, from the Rio Olympics next year. So if these findings are correct, we're asking the question, should Russia be banned from the next Olympic Games?
In my opinion, Russia shouldn't be banned, but those athletes that were found guilty of drugs should absolutely be banned. But I don't think it's fair to ban the ones that have genuinely worked hard to get there. I don't think that's proving anything. I'm just upset, really. It just upsets me because you look up to these people, you know, they're and you admire them for everything, you know, the hard work and the training. And the thing is, I know that even with drugs, they still have to, they're still getting up at 4 or 5 in the morning and doing all the training. But I don't know, I'm just upset because to me, however they paint it, it's cheating.
Yeah.
And I hate cheat.
Yeah. I think as well, does it leave a question mark for you? You said, you know, I don't think all athletes should be banned. You know, the whole Russian team shouldn't be banned. But does it leave that question mark over everybody? Do we now watch athletics or any sports actually now? You know, we know cycling with Lance Armstrong, it was discovered he'd been doping as well. So do you now watch sport with a question mark over your head and go, they really done that
themselves? It's not just doping, all sport, because how many football matches are rigged? How many cricket matches are rigged? And that's results being controlled by betting and people, high rollers, placing huge sums of money on the outcome. So you could say that those cricketers or those football players or goalkeepers are cheats too, because they're manipulating the end result. But in this instance, we're talking about drugs, and it's not just Russia, because Dick Pound, the man that conducted this investigation, the head of the World Anti-Doping Agency, has already said that the US, the American track and field teams, that within them there's widespread doping, and he said that.
So it's the tip of the iceberg.
Yeah, he said it's the tip of the iceberg. And I expect in many countries around the world, athletes are taking drugs and managing somehow to evade drug testing. And what you have to ask yourself is, why don't they just test them the minute they enter the stadium or the minute they complete the race?
I think they should do it the minute they win. I think first, second and third should be instantly drug tested.
Well, you know, I mean, I want to play devil's advocate here. Now, I completely do not condone the doping, and I don't condone the use of performance-enhancing drugs. But what constitutes cheating? Because you have other countries who have state-of-the-art facilities that other countries do not have. Does that not give them an unfair advantage? Is that not enhancing their performance and putting other people at a disadvantage? I know it's not the same thing, but can it not be put in a similar
but
category,
you know,
don't
what?
You think?
You have touched on a point there that's quite interesting, because athletes from all from Britain and America and Russia train in different countries.
Yeah.
So do we think that a British athlete should only train in Britain and only train on our facilities, because they actually routinely fly to high altitude places and they have sponsors, and some athletes have much more behind them than other athletes.
It's budget, and it's budget related a lot of the time, but isn't it?
And then you have other countries who have no chance of that type of training, and so therefore no chance of winning a medal.
Isn't the other thing at the back of all this, why did Russia do it? If this is true, why did Russia do it? And I'll tell you why. It's because sport is being used as propaganda, and the more medals they win, the more Russia looks great. And all countries are guilty of that to a certain degree.
Super Saturday was so exciting. I mean, that was just watching it on the TV. And for the people there who'd paid hundreds of pounds for their tickets and gone into lotteries to get a ticket, you know,
well,
it was the most exciting night. These people
have all been shortchanged. Everybody who bought an Olympic ticket, entered the lottery, has been shortchanged.
But then again, that's like tarring everybody with the same brush, isn't it?
Yeah.
We're now going, can we ever look at these kind of sports again and trust people? And you don't just do that alone. People have trainers and managers and coaches, you know, and it's widespread. It's like a cancer, isn't it?
Well, I think the next Olympics, we ought to look at it and think, drugs are being used here. They will not eradicate drugs, and that's a sad fact.
But they should be.
Yeah, why not?
I don't think it's enough for us just to say that.
It's a big task for Seb Coe, and you've got to ask yourself, is he up to it?
He's got a big job ahead of him, hasn't he? Absolutely.